Hey everyone, welcome back to part 10 of our Endless Runner tutorial series. Today, we're going to add magnet power up. This is part 10.1. In part 10.2, you will learn how to add a progress bar that gets shorter as the power-up countdown gets closer to zero. Before starting the video, if you don't have the magnet model, you can download the one I used in the video from the link in the description. Let's get started. First, in Unreal Engine, go to the content browser, then navigate to the meshes folder inside the runner folder. Import the magnet model you downloaded into the folder. After importing, open the red material that came with the magnet. From the metallic pin, add a constant node and set its value to 1. Duplicate it and connect the duplicate to the roughness pin, changing its value to 0.3. Copy these two constant nodes, open the gray material, and paste them, connecting them to the metallic and roughness pins. Select the parameter node connected to the base color and in the Details tab, select the default value and reduce the value slightly, but don't make it too dark. Save the changes. Now, when you open the magnet mesh, you'll notice it looks much better. Now, let's create the magnet collectible. Go to the Blueprints folder, select BP underscore coin, and duplicate it by pressing Ctrl plus D, name the duplicate BP underscore power up underscore magnet. Open it. In the viewport, select the coin mesh, change the name from coin to magnet, and in the Details tab, change the static mesh from coin to magnet we imported. Set the scale to 0.08 and rotate it minus 90 degrees on the x-axis. Set the y-axis rotation to 0 and the z-axis location to 85. In the event graph, delete everything after the runner game mode node, except for the playsound 2D node. Connect the execution pins from the sound dropdown to the pickup sound. You can use either the coin pickup sound from my previous video or another sound from Unreal Engine starter content. In this case, I'm using the camera underscore shutter sound from the starter content to differentiate between coins and power-ups. Select cast to BP underscore obstacle underscore wall and destroy actor, then move them down. From the PlaySound 2D node, add a set actor hidden in game node and tick new hidden. Compile and save. In the level, add the magnet blueprint and reset the location by clicking the arrow beside the location values to make sure the magnet's position and size are correct. In the magnet blueprint viewport, select the mesh and change the z-axis location from 85 to 95. Now, open BP underscore runner character and create a new variable named isMagnetActive with the type set to Boolean. Compile and save. In the magnet blueprint event graph, as runner character, add getIsMagnetActive. From it, add a branch node. Connect the execution pin to the set actor hidden in gaming node. Now, as runner character, Adset is magnet active. Connect the execution pin to the false pin of the branch node, and enable is magnet active. After set is magnet active, add a print string node and set the string value to magnet active. Then, add a delay node and set the duration to the desired time for the power-up to last. For this video, I'm setting it to 5 seconds. Duplicate the set is magnet active and print string nodes. Connecting the set is magnet active execution pin to the completed pin of the delay. Untick the box of set is magnet active and change print string string value from magnet active to magnet inactive. Finally, from the print string execution pin, add a destroy actor node. Don't forget to connect the target pin of the set is magnet active to the as runner character pin of the cast to runner character node, which I forgot to do earlier. Go to the level and press play. Collect the magnet we placed earlier and check if it works. As you can see, it's working. Now, let's make them spawn in the level. Open the BP_floor blueprint, select the coin spawn points function, and duplicate it, naming it power ups spawn points. In this function, if you want the magnets to spawn in two rows, change the for loop node. Set the first index to 1, the last index to 2, and adjust the multiply value to around 200 or 250. In the construction script, drag and drop the power ups spawn points function to the execution pin of the last node and then compile it. Inside the power up spawn points, change the arrow color to differentiate the other arrows, and remove the C spawn points from the array pin of the add node. Promote it to a new variable called P spawn points. Compile it and go to the viewport. You'll notice that the arrows spawn in two rows. Now, go to the event graph, duplicate the spawn coins function, and name the duplicate spawn power-ups. Open the function and replace C spawn points with P spawn points. Delete the for loop node and the random integer in range. Connect the execution pins and select the add child actor component node. In the details tab, change the actor class to BP_powerups_magnet. Compile the blueprint. You can delete the switch on int as it won't affect spawning. Go to the construction script and drag and drop the spawn power ups function onto the execution pin of the last node. Compile and go to the viewport. You can now see the magnets spawning. Now, go to the level and press play. The magnets are spawning, but we don't want them to spawn in every single tile. To fix this, open the BP_runner game mode. Create a new variable called floor count with the type set to integer. In the add floor function, after the add node, add an increment integer node. Connect the get floor count variable to the input pin of the increment int node. Then, drag and drop the floor count variable onto the return value of the increment int and connect the execution pins. This will keep track of the number of floors spawned. Compile the blueprint. Now, go to the BP underscore floor, and in the Spawn Power-Ups function, select the Spawn Power-Ups node and move it away from the other nodes. Right-click and add a Get Game Mode node. From it, add a Cast to Runner Game Mode. As Runner Game Mode, add Get Floor Count from it and connect it to a greater than node, setting the value to 5 or more. I want the magnet to spawn every 5 tiles, so I will set the value to 5. You can adjust this value as needed. From the return pin of the greater than node, add a branch node and connect the true pin to the random spawn point node. Now, as runner game mode, add set floor count and move it near the add child actor component. Connect the execution pins and set the value to 0. This will reset the floor count every time it spawns a magnet, ensuring it spawns every 5 tiles. Compile and save. In the level, press play. You can now see that the magnets activate, but they don't deactivate. This is because the floor is being destroyed before the magnet deactivates. We'll fix this later in the video. For now, let's make the coins collect automatically when the magnet is active. Open BP underscore coin in the event graph. From the second pin of the sequence, add cast a BP underscore power up underscore magnet, then add a destroy actor node and connect the object pin to the other actor pin. In the Components tab, add a Sphere Collision, set its size to around 30. When your character overlaps this collision with the magnet active, the coin will slide toward the character and be collected. Select the Sphere Collision and, in the Details tab, scroll down to One Component Begin Overlap. Click the plus icon beside it. From the other actor, cast to runner character, as runner character, add get is magnet active. From it, add a branch node. For the true pin, add a timeline node and name it slide. Change the play pin to play from start by holding control. Open the timeline and add a vector track, naming it transition or slide, and set the track length to 2. Return to the event graph. From the update pin, add set actor location. From the transition pin, add an addition node, connecting the return value to the new location pin of the set actor location node. Now, right-click in an empty space and add a get actor transforming node. From it, add break transform. From the location pin of break transform, add Vinterp 2. Right-click in an empty space again and add get player character. From it, add get actor location. Connect the return value to the target pin of the Vinterp 2 node. Add get world delta seconds from delta time and set the interp speed to around 20. Connect the return value to the addition pin. Now, select the coin, scroll down in the details tab until you find on component begin overlap, and click the plus icon. Move this node near the event actor begin overlap. Change the nodes connected to event actor begin overlap to one component begin overlap by holding control. Delete event actor begin overlap. Compile and save. Go to the level and press play. You'll see that after collecting the magnet, the coins move toward the character and are collected. However, when you exit the game, you might get an error like this. To fix this, go to the magnet blueprint. In the event graph, select all the nodes after the delay node and move them slightly. Then, add a Get Player Character node and cast to Runner Character. Connect the execution pins to the delay and is magnet active. Don't forget to alt-click on the target pin to disconnect it from the previous pin and cast to Runner Character. Connecting it to the target pin of a set is magnet active. Go to the level and press play. You can now collect coins with the magnet. However, the magnet will not disable as I mentioned before. This is because the floor is destroyed before the magnet is deactivated. To fix this, go to the BP_runner game mode in the extend floor function. Change the value of the addition node to 10 or more. If your power-up lasts more than 15 seconds, I recommend setting it to the same as your power-up duration. However, do not set it higher than 40, as this can cause performance issues. Go to the level and press play again. You will see that the magnet is now deactivated after 5 seconds. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you encounter any errors or need assistance, feel free to contact me via email or Discord. You can find the details in the description. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.